Most people with infertility will attempt to conceive with IUI before trying IVF. There are many so-called fertility diets. Which one is best during treatment with IUI? We finally have a well-done scientific study on this topic. Stay tuned and I will explain. Hi, I'm Dr. Randy Morris. If you are new to my channel, I am a fertility expert. I review complicated scientific studies about infertility and summarize them in an understandable way for free. You will not find anyone trying to sell you books or supplements here, just real, unbiased, scientific-based recommendations. Today, I am going to talk about different diets and their impact on the chance of having a live-born baby with IUI. If you are looking for my review on IVF diets, then watch this episode. IUI, if you don't know, stands for intrauterine insemination. This is the process of inserting sperm directly into the uterus at the time of ovulation to maximize the chances for pregnancy. IUI, often combined with fertility medications, is a common treatment for couples with low sperm quality, but is also used for couples with unexplained infertility. The study I am going to talk about today was conducted in Massachusetts as part of the Environment and Reproductive Health Study. In this part of that study, they recruited women with infertility who were planning fertility treatment with IUI. They completed an extensive questionnaire about their diet over the past year. They determined how closely women followed one of several different diet plans. They looked at three different versions of the Mediterranean diet, two different versions of the Healthy Eating Index, the DASH diet, the American Heart Association 2020 Diet Dietary Goals Index, and a plant-based diet. In total, they evaluated 8 different healthy diets. Women were sorted into 4 groups based on how well they followed these diets. Group 1 followed the diets very closely. Group 4 did not follow the diets very closely. The average age of women in the study was 35. Importantly, these are women who had normal weight. Their BMI or body mass index was in the normal range. About 300 women were recruited and completed the questionnaire, and they completed just over 800 IUI cycles. About 80% of the women were white, about 10% were Asian, and about 5% were black. Around 40% had unexplained infertility, 40% had a male factor, and the remainder had a female factor. They did not provide more specifics about the type of infertility factors. But what were the results? None of these diets resulted in a higher chance of live birth from an IUI cycle. None. Let me emphasize this a little bit more. If you follow some influencer who says that you should eat a plant-based diet to improve your IUI success, you will now know that this recommendation is their opinion and not based on scientific data. Same for the Mediterranean diet. Same for the DASH diet. Same for all 8 of the diets studied. Just because a diet is considered a healthy diet or is rich in fruits and vegetables does not mean it will make it more likely for you to conceive when doing IUI. Now, this study, like all studies, has some limitations. None of the women in this study were obese. Could one or more of these diets have been helpful if they studied obese women? Maybe. We won't know that answer until that study is done. Another potential limitation has to do with women who do not ovulate. Certain diets have been shown to improve the likelihood for ovulation. It is also possible that this study simply wasn't large enough to find a benefit. In general, the smaller the benefit, the more people you need in your study to be able to demonstrate that benefit. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. Currently, the best scientific evidence does not show a benefit to changing your diet in order to produce the chance for an IUI live birth success. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.